Still in Cagayan, the provincial government says no casualties have been reported so far due to the storm. Governor Miguel Mamba, however, warns of floodings as incessant rains feed the Cagayan River and its tributaries. In the meantime, officials are still assessing damage inflicted by Typhoon Egay on crops and infrastructure. Power is also down in northern Cagayan.
I believe not, but this will not end to the typhoon because our rivers are now swelling. No, and water is just coming down the range, the mountain ranges. So that is why we are again expecting flooding in along Cagayan River and its tributaries. Mm. That is why I am forewarning people to that this will not end with that super typhoon leaving us, but we still have to address the swelling of the Cagayan River and that of the Abulug River, because these are the ones also causing most of our damages, especially our crops.
Strong winds whipped Batanes in the northern Philippines brought by Typhoon Egay. Small trees, motorcycles, and some light structures were no match for Egay's winds. Several business establishments, including banks, were also closed. The Batanes Emergency Operations Center says they are ready to distribute food packs to affected residents and respond to emergencies. In the town of Ivana, four families were forced to leave their homes as violent winds threatened to topple their homes, which are made from light materials.
The Philippine Disaster Management Agency says more than 180,000 individuals are currently affected by the inclement weather brought by Typhoon Egay and the southwest monsoon. The agency reports over 2,000 families were preemptively evacuated. Disaster officials also confirm one fatality and two individuals who sustained injuries. They note 51 cities and towns were affected by power outages. 30 domestic flights were also canceled due to the bad weather. Meanwhile, President Marcos, who is currently in Malaysia for a three-day state visit, said government has prepared 175 million pesos in standby funds. Rescue personnel have also been deployed while food and other items have been sent to northern Luzon.
Ilocos Norte is now under a state of calamity due to severe flooding and strong winds brought about by Typhoon Egay. Provincial Board Member Dante Franklin Despicio says there was a need to declare a state of calamity so the provincial government can realign funds for the repair and rehabilitation of damaged properties and infrastructure, which are pegged at hundreds of millions of pesos. A number of residents were also rendered homeless due to the typhoon. Disaster officials are now making the rounds in various evacuation centers in Pagutpod and Bangi to provide food packs and other essentials.
Philippine telco giant PLDT Smart sets up a command center in the province of Pampanga to assess the impact brought by Typhoon Egay. PLDT says it's been monitoring its services and resources 24/7 to ensure the stability of its fixed and wireless networks in times of disaster. The group also notes its services remain available, except in areas affected by power outages. An update on Typhoon Egay. Egay maintained strength as it made its second landfall in the Lupiri Island, which is part of the Babuyan group of islands. The typhoon is moving northwest with maximum sustained winds of 165 kilometers per hour. Signal number 4 is still hoisted over the extreme northern Luzon. State meteorologists forecast Egay will move northwest of Batanes and outside of the Philippine area of responsibility by Thursday. PNP Chief General Benjamin Acorda Jr. is seeking a clarification from Malacañang over the decision of President Marcos to accept the courtesy resignation of 18 officials allegedly involved in the illegal drug trade. ABS-CBN correspondent Raya Capulong joins us on the line for the details of that. Raya?
Ron, PNP Chief General Benjamin Acorda Jr. said they will wait for the official copy of the document in connection to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. accepting the resignation of 18 third-level officers of the PNP who are allegedly involved in illegal drug activities before he makes a decision. According to Acorda, he is requesting a meeting in Malacañang to clarify things. Acorda said that it is possible for the 18 police officers to face criminal and administrative cases And some of these names have already faced charges based on the recent investigation by the SITG. Acorda added that the officials whose resignations were accepted are being continuously monitored. Ron?
Raya Kapulong with that story. Thanks for that. Now, in related news, senators are one in saying police officials with supposed drug links or those involved in irregularities should be held accountable. Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva says these officers must be charged in court. He maintains resignation is not enough. Senator Francis Escudero agrees, adding that slapping appropriate cases should be the next logical step. Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III and Senator Ramon Revilla Jr. both say the police investigation and gathering of evidence must continue.